the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with Doug Allen.
Getting into a bit of a rhythm now, it would seem, doesn't it? Every couple of days or so, you get a little blast of winter coming on by. Our morning winter weather maker is off the map for the most part. A couple of flurries northwestern PA. Going to fly across northern sections of the valley here in the next couple of hours. That'll ensure that we have some clouds around more than anything else during the evening hours. Our next weather maker of significance, still back here in the plains, making his way into Missouri right now. And really, this guy is chugging right along. It won't waste any time in zipping from here, the center of the country, to the Atlantic coast by Friday morning. So it's going to be here, it looks like, overnight, tomorrow night, that is Thursday night, into Friday morning early. And we'll give you a timetable on this in just a second. Right now, still 38 degrees, a little thaw going on today. One word of caution as we see some melting going on, some of that water on the roadways. Watch for the refreeze tonight because it will be getting colder, obviously, after sunset. We're at 39 in York now, 39 in Lebanon. Lancaster, Harrisburg both at 38. Gettysburg's at 39, along with Chambersburg. So mostly cloudy and chilly this evening, 32 to 36. Overnight tonight, it'll get colder. The clouds will break a little bit, 18 to 24. Degrees. And then for the day tomorrow, after some early sunshine, those clouds are going to roll right in with temperatures much cooler than today at 28 to 32. So most of us will not break the freezing point. Here's what it looks like now in the satellite and the radar view. This is the morning weather maker that we had that scooted on by. And this little disturbance is riding along right now along I-80 in northern PA now. And that's going to just bring a couple of flurries maybe to northern parts of the valley, Union, Snyder counties, maybe around Mifflin County, maybe even Schuylkill County. But that is about it. That'll cruise on through here harmlessly. On the predictor, you can see the clouds thinning a little bit later tonight. Maybe waking up tomorrow, you see a little bit of sunshine, and then the clouds are just going to go right back over us again. Here's tomorrow evening. So you boil this down, you're fine for the commute tomorrow morning. You'll be fine for the commute tomorrow afternoon. Friday morning might be a bit slow as some snow overspreads the area late Thursday evening, early Friday night. The majority of it looks like it comes around 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning, Friday morning, and that's as the system is shifting its energy to form a new storm center offshore. So we will get some snow out of this, and we'll take a look at that. But notice how quickly it shuts off again because it's reforming offshore and scooting away. Now, behind this, some big changes, and it's going to get mighty cold this weekend, it looks like. But generally, this will probably leave across the valley about 2 to 5 inches of accumulation. First look at this. Stay tuned for fine-tuning as we get closer. From around the Mason-Dixon line in south, we're talking a coating to maybe a couple of inches and really tapering off to just about zero once you get down to Washington, D.C. So tomorrow, becoming cloudy, a little bit of snow early in the morning on Friday. Then it gets windy and cold. Saturday's high around 20. Watch these low temperatures and daytime highs. Sunday's high 24. The overnight low Sunday into Monday, probably around 8. And then struggling to get back to about the freezing point by next Wednesday. So watch for the refreeze tonight.